You were more focused on the entertainment
events,
part,
exactly.
On the events.
I was
side.
Completely like, forget logistics, forget how you do it, let's just do it, you know, let's do the events. But I started realizing like I really like the creative side of it. So giving a concept to an event, the name, creative packages that we're gonna create for that day. So we started like that. We got one account, from one account it went to two accounts, and then we went three accounts, and we're like, okay, this is becoming something.
Mind Miami is a team of creative problem solvers. Their integrated marketing approach allows your business goals to be expressed in more than just the traditional sense. Mind Miami offers their clients online solutions to maximize their sales and widen their reach. Now, here's your host of the Entrepreneurial Vibration Show, Sandy Viteri.
Good morning, everyone, and here we are today with Gabby Muti from Mind Miami. And Mind Miami is a creative agency. So, hi Gabby, how are you doing today?
Hello, thank you so much for having me.
No, thank you for having me. We're here today with Gabby so she can tell us how they got started and tell us about their background and what they do for everybody here in Miami. So, why don't you tell us, how do you guys
Absolutely.
Get started?
So, Mind Miami, what's Mind Miami? Mind Miami is a creative agency that we work with different industries, not just like nightlife, real estate, influencers, and what we do is we kind of create a creative approach that represents your brand in how you want to see your brand. You know what I mean? So you have a vision of your brand, we want to help you communicate that vision. So that's through social media, web development, content creation, photography, videos, graphic design, everything, and try to incorporate all those elements together so you have like one integrated marketing communication.
Beautiful. But why don't you tell us
how did it get started?
Okay. Yes.
I'm jumping right into the process. So yes. Mind Miami, it's actually kind of a funny story. This isn't my first business attempt, you know, so the
because you're an entrepreneur by
I'm
nature.
An entrepreneur, yes,
because
both of
you
my
have
parents,
it in your DNA.
Definitely, both of my parents are entrepreneurs, they're both business owners, and I kind of had that chip inside of me all the time. So the first business I tried was actually an event company. So we would like target different nightlife, we would do pop-up events once a month and stuff like that, and it kind of started creating a relationship with all of these nightlife companies, you would say. And then little by little they started seeing like, wow, you guys create these events so good, like the marketing of these events, like the image that you give this events, and we're like, yeah, it's pretty good, you know. And then they're like, why don't you do it for me? So it kind of started that way. So I got one account, which was a nightclub in Brickell. I started creating like their graphic design, like their communication, everything. And I did this as well with my boyfriend, which he had a marketing agency in Ecuador, Mind Ecuador. And then when he came to Miami, he started telling me all about it, but he was doing something else, like he was working like in technologies and stuff like that. So I was like, oh, why don't you help me out with this? So I'm like, okay, let's do this. So
but you were more focused on the entertainment
events,
part,
exactly.
On the events
I was
side.
Completely like, forget logistics, forget how you do it, let's just do it, you know, let's do the events. But I started realizing like I really like the creative side of it. So giving a concept to an event, the name, creative packages that we're gonna create for that day. So we started like that. We got one account, from one account it went to two accounts, and then we went three accounts, and we're like, okay, this is becoming something, you know?
Yeah.
Let's put a little more serious thought into it. So we started expanding our team. We hired a group of graphic designers and a web developer. So we started just staying away from social, like not just focusing on social media, but focusing a little more on the whole 360 approach.
Experience, the whole experience.
The whole experience,
of
exactly. Because at the end of the day, we wanted to all make sense. We wanted to have one communication, what you're communicating online on the web. It's the same thing you're communicating on Instagram, Facebook, Google, like whatever it is, you know? So then that's how it started growing. 2 years later, we have a wide variety of different industries and a huge team that we're actually expanding now. So
beautiful.
It's pretty cool.
Very nice. You know, that is so important that, you know, the way that you started, you actually were looking at just one piece of the whole event, right? And then little by little, you started realizing that there were actually arms and legs and different areas that you could actually tap into.
Definitely.
And by partnering with your boyfriend, then you started actually growing and growing your business. So very good, very smart. And then not only that, but you also started looking at the different industries, right? You started with only the nightclubs and that scene, but then you started going into all the different industries. Very good, very nice. And also now, as you said, you're actually going also geographically, you're expanding geographically. You're going into New York, you're going into Ecuador. Mm-hmm. Very good. So tell me a little bit about that experience. What is that experience like? Like having now a satellite office or people working for you in New York and also Ecuador?
Of course. So it's something that we thought about from the very beginning. Once we realized that this was actually becoming something big, we always thought, okay, we want to grow. You know, we don't want to just stay here in Miami. Right. Although we love Miami,
yeah,
we want to be able to have different teams and apply what we know and like grow.
Right.
I think it's very important to not leave all the work to yourself, but I think when the moment that you start trusting others and letting them continue your idea or something like that, and maybe they can contribute new ideas, I think that's like how you actually become a global company. So yes, right now we just started New York. We got 2 new clients in New York.
Nice.
And Ecuador, it's been running as well. And our next stop, it's Madrid. So we can't wait for that to happen.
Mm-hmm. Very good, very good. Now, in order for you to be able to expand geographically, you have to have a very good structure, a very good process first, very established here locally. So how did you go about establishing that process here?
So, okay, this is why it's me and my boyfriend, we're a team. He's the one that does it, like gets things done, and I'm the one that has to like plan. Like I was the biggest nerd in school, you know, so I had to like make sure I took all my notes. I probably have like 10 different notebooks with to-do lists, but I like making sure I don't miss a single thing, you know, and that's why we work so well together, because he's executing and I'm making sure planning and nothing's being missed. So once we were able to like sit down one night, we're like, let's just, you know, like write it all down, like what do we know and all this. We were able to like target like, okay, like what's our procedure, like what's our methodology, like what do we want to contribute to these clients, like what's our service that we're going to offer, whether it's social media, okay, what about social media, how are we going to manage this social media. So writing everything down, sitting down with all these people that we find would be a valuable integration to our team. We teach them, okay, what do you think about this? Like, we also want to know what you have to say and like how you can contribute, and take this and run. It's your show. Knowing what we're giving you, the tools, we share as well some of our resources. So making sure you have our creative team always there to help you if you have any question or stuff like that. But it's your show. We trust in your creative approach.
So would you say that for each of the areas that you now have established, have you created something that is called a standard operating procedures?
Yes and no. So we do have standard procedures to follow, but at the same time, we understand each market is a little different. So in Miami, you know, we have a lot of Hispanics and stuff like that. So we can play a little with like that whole Spanglish communication. But then you go to New York and it's a little more like corporate, like, you know what I mean?
So right.
You can play with a different communication,
but you're flexible still.
Exactly. And then in Spain, like, for example, surprisingly enough, we found that social media isn't even all that big over there. Over there it's more direct marketing, because a lot of people actually retire in Madrid, so you have like a lot of like older people. So depending on what your objective is, then we have to like play with those standard procedures.
So to that point, then you're very culturally aware.
It's key. You have to study your market and understand what you're dealing with, because
every culture is different.
Exactly. The same marketing cannot apply to every single country or every single industry. You have to do a market research for everything. And I found this so cool, because I started working with clients that like I had no idea, like real estate, like I see it in there, but like I don't really know. And then I have to like read about it, like understand about it. And I think this kind of job like helps you understand so many other industries that are outside your comfort zone.
Right. That is instrumental. So for all the entrepreneurs out there, a few keys, like few hacks, as I would call it. Not only, yes, create your standard operating procedures, but having an understanding of your target market, then understanding the different cultural differences by industry or by country. So very good. Thank you for that. Thank you for sharing that. So moving along and, you know, talking about your experience in your entrepreneurial journey. So what are some of the lessons learned?
Now, we would love to hear from you. Tell us on the comments below. Was this advice helpful to you today? And how can you put some of what you learn into practice right away to start to see a difference in your entrepreneurial journey? Also, don't forget, if you found this podcast helpful, make sure to subscribe, share with your friends, and hit the like button so we know to make more podcasts like this one.